children, a very good morning to all. Welcome back to our English class. In our previous class, we finished our explanation part and we finished our textual exercises. Today, you are going to learn about grammar, nouns. Now, let us open your grammar textbooks. Be ready with your pencils. Shall we start our grammar? Yeah, let's start. Good morning, children. Now, open your grammar textbooks. Page number 22. Today we will learn about genders. So what are genders? Genders are, we know two genders, that is female and male gender, right? So here let us see what is that. Nouns can be of different genders. Nouns that refer to a man or a boy or of the masculine gender. So listen carefully. Masculine means a male. It is, we call it as male gender. It is male gender. Masculine means male gender, like father, grandfather, boy, uncle. All this comes under male gender. Okay. So, masculine means male gender. Remember that. Example, see here. Boy, line, father, uncle, grandfather. Okay. All the male genders comes under this masculine gender, right? Now, nouns that refer to a girl or a woman or of the feminine gender. So, if this is male gender and this is female gender, we call this as female gender. What is this? It is female gender, like our sister is female gender. That means mother, grandmother, aunt, girl, all this comes under female gender. Okay. Nouns that refers to both male and female or common gender. So, we know very well for male and female gender. If it is a boy, we call as male. If it is a girl, we call it as female. If it is grandfather, we call male gender. If it is grandmother, it is female gender. But here some genders are there. That means they don't have whether it is a male or a female, we call both as the same. That means, for example, if you take friend, so would you shall we call a girlfriend a boyfriend like that? No, we won't call friends. Do somebody ask you, do you have friends? Yes, we have friends. And children, do you understand? If friend is common gender, that means if it is a boy or a girl, we call as friend. Okay, like that we have baby. If it is a baby boy or a baby girl, we call as baby. Cousins. Cousins means our aunt and uncle's children. We call them as cousins. If it is a boy or a girl, we call as cousins only, no? Friend. If we have friends like boys or girls, we call them as friends only, neighbors. Whether they are boy, whether a family is living, what we say, we call them as our neighbors, teacher. If it is a female or a male teacher, we call as teachers, like that. So there is no change in these type of genders are called, these type of genders are called as common genders. Nouns that refers to things that are neither male nor female are of the neuter gender. So these are not a male or not a female. They don't come, neither it is male or nor a female. Both. And they don't have any gender. Okay. They are neuter gender. Like book, swing, grass, glass, mountain, city. All these are neuter gender. That means they don't have any male or female gender. Certain nouns in the masculine can be changed into the feminine by adding es. So here there are some genders. That means there are some genders of male we have to change by adding es to that word. We have to change them into feminine. That means a male changes to female if we add ess to that particular word. For example, host, it is hostess. Here they have added es. Line is male and lioness is female. Line is male, Lioness is female. Like that, some more examples. Tiger, tigress. Tiger is male. Very good. Tigress is, yeah, very good. Very good. It is, tigress is female. Like that, we have to add ES for some genders to change male into female. Okay. For some more nouns, the masculine can be changed into feminine by adding ES after dropping the last vowel. So here, some masculine genders are there. Why? After adding ES, they have to drop the last vowel. That means the last letter of the vowel has to drop. See here, observe. Waiter. It is waiter. The last vowel in the sentence, in the word is E. What are vowels? A, E, I, O, U are vowels, right? A, E, I, O, U. These five are called as vowels, right? Are vowels. So here in this word, what is the vowel? Last vowel. Last. Yeah, it is E. So we have to drop. That means this is male, right? This is male gender. We have to drop. That means we have to cut this. We should not write in the female gender. We should not write this letter in the female gender. And we have to write waitress. We have to add ESS to this, turns to ESS. When we add ESS, it becomes feminine. Let us say feminine. Waitress. What is the spelling? W-A-I-T-R-E-S-S. Here the spelling is W-A-I-T-E-R. Waiter. So here E is there. This is vowel, right? This is vowel. And here, observe the spelling. Waitress. There is no in between T and R. Is there E? Yeah, it is not there. So you have to cut that E and you have to write waitress. Again, observe this. Tiger, tigress. In between G and R, E is not there. So you have to cut off that E. Like that, some feminine genders are there. Okay. In some cases, the feminine is formed by using an entirely different word. For example, here we are just adding ESS, or here we are adding ES. But in some cases, we have to change. That means the word completely change. For example, bull, cow. Bull, cow. Observe the words. Bull, this is male. Very good. Cow is female. Here, the word is changed. Observe that. Of, fox. Fox is male. Yes, fox, male fox. This is vixen. This is female. Female fox is called as vixen. This is buck. This is doe. Buck, doe. Right? So now we have to do, according these principles, we have to do the exercise. Let us check. Fill in the blanks with the feminine gender of the noun. So here they have given male genders. We have to write female genders, right? Let us see. In the box, they have given some words. Let us check. Actress, maid, goose, duck, washerwoman, hen, queen, bee. So here they have given animals and here they have given people. Let us check which word suits for this. Animals. This is drake. This is male. And this is female, right? Don't write like this, ma. For your clear clarification, I am writing here like this. Okay, to make you easy to understand, I am writing this. So, no, don't write this. Just copy the answers. Okay, na, ma? Male. All this comes under male. And this is female. Let us check. Drake. Drake is male. Duck. And duck is female. We call female duck is called as duck and male duck is called drake. Okay. Rooster, hen. Roaster, hen. This is roaster. Roaster is male hen. Hen is female. We call female hen is hen only. And rooster is female. Rooster is male. Okay. Now, drone. Bee. So, male bee is called drone. And female bee is called bee. Bee means honeybee. Okay. Gander. This is gander. Goose. Gander. Goose. Gander. Goose. And now this is about people. Here we discussed about animals and this is peoples. So here this is male gender and this is female gender. So Stalin is male and male is female. Washerman, washerwoman. King, queen. Actor, actress. So now we have to write gender in the sentence form, right? So in a sentence form we have to write gender. Change the gender of the underlined noun and rewrite the sentence. You may need to make other changes. So what you have to do, they have given sentences and they have underlined some words, that means nouns. For that nouns we have to change the gender and we have to rewrite the sentence in the given blank. Let us check. We saw a tiger in the jungle with his cubs. So what is the underlined word here? Tiger. We already know that tiger is male and tigress. What you have to do? You have to drop this last vowel. So what is the spelling of tigress? T-I-G-R-E-S-S. Okay. So now the sentence is, we saw a tigress in the jungle with her cubs. Okay. Now let us look second one. The girl walked to school with her brother. So here what is the underlined word? It is girl and brother. So what have to change here? You have to change if the gender is male, you have to change it in female. If the gender is female, you have to change it in male. Okay. Here girl, the gender changes to boy, right? Girl is female and boy is male. The boy walked to school with her. Here it is brother. Brother is, yes, male. Very good. So what is the female gender of brother? Yeah, it is sister. So you have to write sister. So the sentence is, the boy walked to school with her sister, right? Third one, there are 4 cows and 4 horses on the farm. Underlined word is cows and horses. So what is this? Yes, very good. This is feminine gender. So you have to change this word to male. Okay, masculine gender. So that is cow changes to bulls and horses changes to mares. Okay. Now the sentence is, there are 4 bulls and 4 mares on the farm. So here cow changes to bull, horses changes to mares, right? My grandfather's brother looks after his orchard. Underlined word is grandfather's brother. So here you have to change. Observe very carefully. Father changes to mother, brother changes to sister. Yes, my grandmother's sister looks after her orchard. Right, children? Don't get confused. Just you need to observe the sentences. Okay. Our landlord lives on the ground floor with his son. Underlined word is landlord and this is son. S-O-N, son. Okay. So, here this is, landlord is male gender. You have to change this into female. Landlord changes to landlady. Son changes to daughter. D-A-U-G-H-T-E-R. Okay, children? Okay. So, here the sentence is, our landlady lives on the ground floor with her daughter. Okay. My aunt Miss Jaya Ramana is a police woman. Aunt, police woman. You have to change this. Aunt changes to, very good, uncle. My uncle Mr. Ramana is a policeman. Sunaina's nephew is 5 years old. So here underlined word is nephew. That means our aunt. Aunt children are called nephew and niece. So Sunaina's niece is 5 years old. The prince want to talk to the queen. Children, can you say this? Yeah, prince become princess. Prince become princess. queen become king, right? So now the sentence is, the princess wanted to talk to the queen become king, right? The bride and her father looked very happy. Looked very happy. So bride, here bride means bride. The bride changes to groom and father changes to mother. Okay, the sentence is now, the groom and his mother looked very happy. Okay, the actress won an art for her role as a princess. So underline words are actress and princess. So we have to change, actress changes to actor, princess changes to prince. Right, now the sentence is, the actor won an award for his role as a prince. Actress changes to actor, princess changes to prince. Right, my niece is the heroine of this film. Niece, already we have seen in the seventh one. So this, my niece, underlined word is niece and heroine. Heroine changes to hero, niece changes to nephew. My nephew is the hero of this film. So write these very properly, complete your grammar book. By this we finish our nouns chapter. Bye-bye children, have a nice day.